Buenos días, good morning. Welcome to Doral and the City Hall. And thank you for joining us today here at City Hall. I want to recognize the Vice Mayor, Bettina Rodriguez Aguilera. Thank you for being here in this press conference. We call this press conference because we want our residents to be prepared for this year's hurricane season. As a Floridian, we face the threat of these storms on a yearly basis, so it can be easy to forget to prepare ourselves and our home for the potential threat of hurricane. We want to ask all our residents to please prepare yourself by taking the necessary precautions and the gathering the necessary supplies for family will need in case we are faced with a storm this year. It is important that you don't wait until the last minute to gather the food, the supplies, and everything you need for this hurricane season. By the time we know for certain that a storm is coming, stores quickly run low on supplies due to the high demand. Please make sure to include in the hurricane supplies water, food, batteries, flashlights, a portable radio or television, and the necessary supplies to help protect your home against strong winds and flying debris. Additionally, I strongly encourage you, residents, to sign up for the red code that we have in our city. If you go to the city webpage, thecityofdoral.com, you will find a code red where you can subscribe yourself and you can download an application where you, all the authority can notify you about any threat you might have in this hurricane season. The system notifies all registered individuals on emergency situation in our city, including hurricanes. Buenos días. Buenos días. Bienvenidos a la ciudad de Doral. Y gracias por acompañarnos en este día. Quiero reconocer a nuestra vicealcaldesa Bettina Rodriguez Aguilera, muchas gracias por estar aquí con nosotros, y a todos nuestros oficiales, al jefe de la policía, a todos los lieutenants y personas que están aquí de nuestro grupo del Departamento de Policía, y a todo el staff de directores que también están haciendo un extraordinario trabajo para que, primero, cuidarnos a nosotros y, segundo, desarrollar una tarea para que nuestra calidad de vida mejore en esta ciudad. He convocado esta rueda de prensa porque queremos asegurarnos de que nuestros residentes estén preparados para la temporada de huracanes. Esto no quiere decir que tenemos que salir temblando a correr desesperados, pero tenemos que estar preparados porque a veces nos agarra de sorpresa y no sabemos qué es lo que puede acontecer. Queremos pedirle a nuestros residentes que por favor tomen las precauciones y cumplan las provisiones, compren las previsiones necesarias que sus familias requieran para esta temporada de tormenta. Es importante no esperar al último momento para buscar las cosas que se necesitan. Cuando un huracán se aproxima, es cuando, o sea, en el último momento todo el mundo sale a correr. Pero cuando llegamos, los estantes están vacíos, no hay agua, no hay comida, porque la demanda, por supuesto, en estos momentos, cuando ocurre el incidente, es alto de todos estos, supplies. Adicionalmente, los invito a que se registren en nuestra ciudad, en nuestra página web, que existe una aplicación que se llama Código Red. Ustedes van allí y se registran, ponen su nombre, su dirección, su teléfono, y allí ustedes bajan una aplicación donde constantemente les va a estar informando de todos los eventos que ocurran de este tipo de desastres que posiblemente no ocurran aquí en el Doral, ni en Miami, ni en el sur de la Florida, pero hay que estar preparado. Y esta aplicación nos va a mantener al tanto de todo lo que esté sucediendo. Este sistema además notifica a los usuarios sobre cualquier situación de desastre en cualquier zona del sur de la Florida. Quiero dejarles con la información de que nosotros no estamos con esta conferencia de prensa alarmando a nadie, ni para que se asusten, ni salgan corriendo. Es simplemente precaución. Hombre precavido vale por dos. Así que los dejo con nuestro jefe de la policía, el señor Richard Blum, quien tiene más información sobre este tema. Muchas gracias por haber venido y por supuesto que Dios me los bendiga a todos.
Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the mayor and the manager for prompting this press conference to deal with the hurricane. I believe it's something that hasn't been done before in Doral, and I have to thank him for taking the time to do that. The purpose of this conference is basically twofold. First, to throw information out, put information out there on what you can do to better prepare for the storm. And the second is basically to get everybody in hurricane mode. It's that time of year. June 1st actually was the beginning of the storm season, and we have our first named storm out there now, Andrew. National Hurricane Center predicts 13 to 20 named storms, and that'll be next this season here. I did meet with the director of the Dade County USC several weeks ago to go over our plans to make sure they're well coordinated with Dade County, as well as to make sure that we had representation in the county USC, which we do. He was able to give me some of the updates that the county has, and we have those on our website, as well as, I went over the updates we have in Doral to make sure, again, it's a coordinated effort. One of the things I came out with when I talked to the county was the new storm surge map, which they just published. It's on our website, it's behind me, and this year they added things to it, and it now includes the city of Doral, which we didn't before. In prior years, they had a map which basically had phases or storm surges for A, B, and C. And that did not include Doral. This year, they've extended the map to have it A, B, C, D, and E. And now when it goes to E, that actually affects the city of Doral. E would be worst case scenario. That would be a category 5 storm when it's a slow moving storm and the tide is high tide. So it's not likely to happen, but they wanted to go ahead and extend that map to show what would happen in the worst case scenario, and that's behind me, and that's E. So it does affect significant portions of Doral, so that's something that's added to our website, as well as on the website we have a hurricane guide that you can download. We have a hurricane hotline that you can call and get information. We have a code red system, which we encourage you to register so you can go ahead and give you information, and also a link to the Dade County USC, which is very important. In addition, we had some changes here in Doral, and one of the changes is, probably the most significant change is we have a new emergency operations center that's located at 99th Avenue and 62nd Street beside the new police station. Although we haven't moved into that building, we'll probably be going in there within the next 6 weeks. And although we're not occupying the building right now, the EOC is functional. It's a Category 5 building, it has its backup generator power, it has its own fuel supply, and that's where we'll be hosting our operations from. And the other good thing is it's not in this E storm surge, so it's outside that. So it's a perfect building to hold operations. We'll be doing things like when you call before the storm, giving you information as far as distribution points, should there be any. Those distribution points for sandbags, for ice, and for anything else, we'll have information on. We'll have at our EOC, the contractors for debris removal. This way, when the storm is over, we can get out there and start removing some of the debris to make it easier for the residents and the people who work here to get around. Having said that, we also have a listing of 23 or more traffic lights, which can be, which actually are ready to go with generators. And Public Works has those generators ready to go. So, after this storm, make life a little bit easier for you people to get around. So basically, we've done a lot to prepare. I've sat with all of the department directors if I could just get them to stand real quick, because I have my guy behind me, but I'd like them to stand up, and I just want to give them a quick round of applause. So, we can help you, because we have a comprehensive plan, but we really need to go over our checklist, to make sure that works for us as first responders and for you as citizens in Doral. And they've been really cooperative. I'm kind of like a new guy here, so a lot of them have been helping me with the plan, and I really need that help. So we've done a lot to prepare. I was actually the emergency manager of the City Miami Police Department for 4 or 5 years back when Wilma hit and Katrina, and this City of Miami is a lot bigger, but you know what, we have some really good points here. And what I saw in the plan, and I've seen since I've been a police chief here, probably the biggest advantage we have is we have active crime watches, whether it's residential crime watches or business crime watches, and really good rapport with the HOAs and homeowners associations. So we have a lot of good contact points that people can call us, we can call them, and we get a lot of information out quickly because of the partnership that the residents of Doral have with not only the police department, but with the department directors here in the city. So that's a real big advantage that I see coming over to Miami here. It's like, boy, you know, you guys are, you know, already part of the team. So before I close, I wanted to mention the Hurricane Fair. Hurricane Fair will be held, I believe it's July 20th at Walnut Park. And as we get information as to what vendors will have, what equipment and supplies there for people to look at, we'll put that on the website. It could be anywhere from the latest generators to radios to work without batteries, kind of like the wind-up radios, storm windows, and things of that nature. As we find out what products will be out there, we put it on the website. It's on a Saturday, it'll make it easy for people to get out there and kind of look at all these things. For questions later on, if you guys want to ask a question, I'll answer as many questions I can now. I do have my staff behind me, somewhere there. And they will, I put it back in because they're going to be the first responders out there. They're going to be in the street, they're going to be, you know, familiar. So I want them to be out there to get familiar with those spaces. But again, get in the hurricane mode. It's an active season. It's a long season, 5 months. Today we have our first named storm. It's the first week of June. When Wilma hit, boy, last time we got hit with a storm was 2005, and that was Wilma, and that is October 23rd. So you can see, here it is, June 6th, but we had another one hit October 23rd, so, you know, we really need to get prepared. And since it's been 8 or so years since we've had a storm hit us, we really need to check our supplies and check our preparations to make sure things haven't changed and make sure we're ready for it.
On the website, everything they need to know as far as evacuations and also.
Bueno, lo que te quiero aclarar es que el edificio no está hecho para la gente o para la evacuación. Está hecho solo para categoría 5 para respaldarnos de lo que es el emergency. O sea, porque en ese sitio nuestros sistemas electrónicos están preparados para soportar esa tormenta, pero no para la evacuación de la gente, porque no tenemos espacio para todos.
So can you say something regarding to public and citizens regarding to play ahead, be proactive, and know where their evacuation places are at?
Basically, yeah, come get on the website.
Actually, we have a website, which is the, mucho mejor. Tenemos la página web de la Policía del Doral, y pueden ir a esa página y obtener toda la información necesaria. Sí tenemos shelters en la ciudad de Doral. Oficialmente tenemos uno para esa persona que no se sientan seguros de estar en la casa. Pueden utilizar ese shelter.
Lieutenant, that's going to be
Ronald Reagan.
Middle school, right?
Hey, Ronald Reagan Hi. Senior High, y Doral Middle School is the second one.
So it all together in a sentence. The shelters son el escuela Ronald Reagan y cuál otra?
Doral Me.
Solo shelter. Doral Miro y
Alberes. Sorry.
Gracias por el español. Alberes.
So we'll have to edit.
Tenemos dos albergues que están disponibles en caso que los ciudadanos necesiten dejar sus viviendas para mejor seguridad. Y esos albergues son Doral Middle School y Ronald Reagan.
El 9 de julio, junto con el alcalde de Sweetwater, vamos a tener una reunión con la gente de Water and Management, o sea, la gente de los acueductos, para hablar de bajar el nivel de los canales Porque muchas de las situaciones que se presentan a veces es que no se abren las compuertas a tiempo o no se baja el nivel de los lagos. Entonces, una de las ideas que se han planteado, y vamos a tener un workshop ese día, el 29 de junio, julio, todos están invitados, se van a bajar esos niveles. Y la idea de esto es que justamente todos los drenajes que ya han sido limpiados por nosotros en reiteradas ocasiones, nos va a permitir a nosotros que drenen hacia esos canales y podamos tener entonces el nivel de agua que queremos. Ustedes han hablado mucho de las calles privadas. El año pasado hubieron cerca de 8 vehículos que se ahogaron, digámoslo así. Y realmente el área de la 34, que es la más afectada, lo que sucede es que son áreas privadas. Ahora, nosotros vamos a prestarle el auxilio necesario, que va a ser a través de bombas. Pero como son zonas privadas, la ciudad tiene que tener mucho cuidado cuando presta este tipo de ayudas, porque puede ser un caso de responsabilidad civil y en algunos casos pues nos podemos poner a la ciudad en una situación difícil.